Until about 15,000 years ago, most of the northern United States was smothered under a glacier many thousands of feet thick. No forests and no animals survived under the crushing weight of the ice. Forests recolonized the land as the glacier receded northward. These woodlands grew in and adapted to conditions that are somewhat different than those to the south that were not glaciated. Most of the trees and understory plants in these forests germinate seeds and root in a spongy mat of organic material on the surface of the soil, known as the forest floor or duff layer. This humus layer is composed of leaf litter, animal remains, and woody debris in varying stages of decomposition. Below the humus is the substrate of inorganic mineral soil. The duff layer is extremely important to our northern forest flora. Trees, wildflowers, and most other plants heavily rely on this layer, from which they absorb organic nutrients. An intact duff layer will contain a large variety of mycorrhizal fungi, which create a vast web of mycelium that actually penetrates or encapsulates plant and tree roots. These fungi cannot photosynthesize to produce their own food. Instead, they draw the sugars they need from tree roots. But they in turn pass water and nutrients collected through their vast mycelium network to the trees and other plants, greatly improving the growth and health of the connected trees. This fungal network also passes chemical defense signals between trees, allowing them to spread the warning of herbivore or insect attack to their neighbors. Each autumn, a new layer of nutrient-rich, freshly fallen leaves is added to the duff layer to be slowly broken down by microbes, bacteria, and other organisms. In some places, the accumulation can be quite thick. Winter snows compress and insulate the leaves, so decomposition can get started. By spring, the layers aren't as fluffy, and wildflowers can emerge. But now, there's a breakdown of the system in some forests. The critically important duff layer is disappearing. There's little or no humus present. Patches of bare ground, mineral soil, are visible. The primary rooting zone of the forest floor is missing. There's little organic material. The reason? It's this, the earthworm. These glaciated forests don't have any native earthworms. Non-native invasive worms from Europe and Asia have been inadvertently introduced in many forests and are eating the organic duff layer faster than it can be replenished each fall. Species such as the common nightcrawler, previously believed to be beneficial to the soil, are now realized to be highly destructive to our northern forests. Once their numbers are high enough, they can completely remove the humus layer, and all you'll see is bare ground, or at most, a thin layer of last year's fallen leaves. Eventually, there may be just some ferns and grasses there. Even the tree seedlings disappear. The most nutritious leaves are eaten first, species such as basswood and sugar maple. Oak leaves are among the last to be consumed. Many animal species also rely on the duff layer for food and shelter, like salamanders, spring peepers and tree frogs, wood frogs, snakes, invertebrates, and mammals. The margins of this stream are home to green herbaceous growth. It's too wet here for earthworms. But just upslope where the ground is drier, worms have invaded and greenery disappears. A seep flowing into the brook harbors lush growth, even tree seedlings. But yards away, the drier ground contains worms, and there's little green growth left. Along this section of stream, you can clearly see the dividing line between the wet area without worms and the drier ground upslope where they are found. Here, there's only one layer of last year's oak leaves, and all green growth has been eliminated. How can you tell if worms are present? Evidence is easy enough to find. Their castings have a characteristic look, a crumbly texture.
There are worm castings.
Pencil-sized holes are evidence of nightcrawler tunnels. Here, a thin layer of last year's oak leaves is all that's left of the duff layer. Below that is mineral soil. A simple test for worms can be done by mixing ground yellow mustard seed in water, about 1/3 cup per gallon. Pour it on a small patch of ground. If worms are active, the mustard irritates their skin and they'll come up out of the ground. A few drops of tea tree oil in soapy water also works well. How did non-native worms get here? Worms advance very slowly by themselves and couldn't match the pace of forests migrating northward after the glaciers retreated. European worms probably first arrived in soil used as ballast in ships of the first colonists. They now get spread as fishing bait in discarded yard waste or in the mulch and compost trade. Eggs can be transported far into a forest in mud caught in boots, in tire treads of ATVs and logging equipment. There is no known way to eliminate non-native worms once they're here. And once they're here, they seriously degrade our northern forests to the point where understory plants and even trees cannot reproduce. There is concern for the survival of many species. Even our sugar maple trees are threatened. Please be aware of this threat and take care not to release or spread earthworms into the forests of the northern states.